right. Moving on. I didn't see South Park last night because I had to check out American Idol.
DVR.
I know. I got it on DVR. I got to go watch South Park when I get home today.
I love it because I wait until Wednesday night. And then like an hour or so before American Idol, I watch the previous night from DVR without commercials. Wah, wah, wah. You know how fast it goes when all you watch are the performances and the judges at the end, what they have to say. Boom, boom, boom. That's all I watch.
It's too good to be true. I've said it many times in this program. This DVR is too good to be true.
And then no waiting, because when you're done with that, you're recording the other one, and then that's done, and then you could zip right to the point where they throw someone off. Hey, I'm done in probably 40 minutes, which amounts to 2.5 hours of programming.
And there's a pattern here, too, because, you know, a lot of people are yelling and screaming at the radio right now, TiVo, TiVo, it's been around for a while. TiVo was too much of a pain in the ass for me to set up ever.
Yeah.
This DVR has made it so easy. It's right on your cable box. Push record, I'm there. It's so easy.
It's part of your cable. You don't have to plug your phone line in.
Anyone else see the pattern here? As soon as things get too easy, then the big guy starts paying attention and going,
steps
all right,
in.
How do we squash this? Kind of like the downloading of illegal music.
Mm-hmm.
It's been going on forever. But
got easy.
When it got easy, that's when they had a problem. Because then more people do it.
Not just the geeks.
And then more people do it. They take away some profit. And then they have to pay attention and do something about it. That's what scares me about the DVR. People are jumping aboard every day. They're realizing an hour show you could watch in like 40 minutes tops, probably even less.
Hour show, American Idol, for every hour you're getting about a half hour program.
Maybe a little, yeah.
Yeah.
It's too good to be true, I'm telling you. Something is going to happen.
You think eventually advertising is going to crack down and they're going to redesign them where you cannot fast forward through the commercials?
Well, you know, I think this new technology challenges people, you know, and it's challenging the record companies, and they've done some cool things because of the downloading of the music and stuff. And now I think these advertisers out there, let's be honest, most commercials suck, and we just are stuck watching them. So maybe this whole DVR phenomenon is going to force them to rethink the whole thing, and maybe it'll get creative again, where you want to sit through the commercials, or maybe they'll go with the, you know, the product placement or whatever.
Or the contest.
Which doesn't bother anyone. I could give a shit when Paula Abdul is babbling and you're sitting there wondering what drug she's on tonight.
She
has a Coca-Cola, you know, cup in front of her. Who cares? I'm all for the product placement as long as it doesn't take away from the actual entertainment of the show.
Dude, Tuesday night's show?
Have them wear logos. I don't give a shit. She was
destroyed. She was so fucked up, in my personal opinion, having seen people that have been on narcotics of some sort, looking at her. She did look like one of those people.
Can I just
her eyes are like half shut. She's like talking about people. You are just a treasure. Ugh. Hammered.
Well, there's something you don't see every day.
What's that?
What, Eric working?
Awful man.
Thanks. Hey, Eric, when you're done, can you get one of the fetchers? I need something.
Oh, what the hell is that? Anyway. You
don't want to get yanked off the air.
For what? Why would it be yanked off the air?
Oh, you can't say anything like that these days. You get fired in certain
that's
markets.
True. Oh, very good. We'll get into that story in a little while. Yes, Jimmy.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, the American Idol thing there, yes.
Yeah.
Watching on DVR, and it goes by nice and fast.
Nice and quickly. None of that filler crap that makes up hours.
So we'll only spend a few minutes on this, but two very interesting things. They finally kicked off Chicken Little.
Lil Kevin.
And Paula Abdul
Levittown
looked like she was going to just cry her eyes out.
Yes.
And I told Anthony, I'm so frustrated with American Idol. Their production value stinks. They need to produce that show better. They're kicking someone off. Because now that it's down to 11, 10 contestants, you know, you've got to know these people.
Yeah, you have
you've invested time in these people. So it's going to get more and more emotional now that these people get kicked off, right?
Yep.
And as soon as they were kicking off Chicken Little, who was a very, very popular contestant in American Idol, you knew the reactions would be great.
Yeah.
You saw like kind of a back shot of like Paris sort of getting emotional, and that was pretty much it. I would have had close-ups going on like crazy.
Yeah.
Because they showed Paula Abdul, like, welling up as it was down to, what, Bucky and Kevin?
Yeah.
And then they never went back to her. You got to think she was crying her eyes out.
You want to see the people weeping.
And the producers of American Idol, they didn't give you those shots for some reason. Because someone's not thinking over there.
No, show the crying people.
Yeah, show the remaining contestants. Like, you know, sad for the one of their fellow contestants being booted off that they all obviously liked, you know. But they missed out on a great opportunity last night, in my opinion.
Yeah.
As far as that goes.
It was pretty much time for Kevin to go. Definitely. When he did his little love song there, just wasn't pulling it off. Sorry.
When I fall in love,
so
it will be forever.
He's right.
Or I'll never fall in love.
She's got a good voice. She should be on Broadway or something, you know?
In a restless world.
Restless world.
Like this is. Love is ended before it's begun.
Yeah, he could be in like Annie.
Exactly.
Moonlight kisses. Seem to cool.
Annie, get your rope.
In the warmth of the sun.
He definitely has a good voice. He just
that worse.
He belongs in like a show, like a play,
yeah.
Broadway.
Well, that's what
something.
He said. I heard a little snippet on the news coming in. He said he's going back to his school there in Levittown and going back to doing the school plays, which I guess he's done a few of. He's probably the one, you know, the drama department probably loves him, the darling.
What a bummer, though. He has to go back to high school? I mean, he's going to be a rock star in the high school.
Oh, forget it. You know, he'll come out on stage and the place will go wild.
He's going to be a rock star, but that's a big step down. You know, they're doing national commercials now and all that.
Yeah, and there he is on stage.
You think they're going to have a day, you know, for him?
Doing Oklahoma.
Wait, did he miss out on the national commercials?
No, well, now it looks
no,
like...
No, he did a couple.
Yeah, now every week the remaining contestants are doing, like, commercials.
There's one less every week.
One less every week.
One less person doing the commercial.
This is what the judges have had to say. And, you know, Simon is the only one that is completely honest. I love this guy. I didn't want to like this guy because this is the first time I've watched American Idol this far, and I thought it was all like, oh yeah, he's being mean to be mean. No, he's being real. And the one who's really not being real is that Ryan Seacrest guy.
Yeah,
he is just god awful with his fake
tool.
With his fake toughness going after Simon. It's like, you know what? Simon's the only one that's being real with these people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is a show that's being seen by what, 40 million Americans. It's not a little cute little school play where you try to be nice to everybody. You know what I mean? This is the real deal. This is the real world. These people are really trying to make it in the business.
You have to stand out like and look like a complete professional.
Like,
on
has Paula Abdul hated anyone yet?
No. Never.
And Randy Jackson is too scared to actually say what he says, so he's always with the, you know.
How'd you feel about that, dog?
Well, I would say it's not
your... You're the judge. Tell me.
I would say it's not your best performance.
You know, but you were having fun up there. You were having fun up there. Yeah.
But, you know.
Yeah, was I?
He does that a lot. But I like you. It's like, ugh. And Simon is just... He doesn't want to be there. His arms are folded. He's laughing, you know, to himself.
It looked like a bad high school performance.
Right. Well, this is
what
the judges said about Kevin.
You chose one of my favorite songs of all time. I love this song. It's one of my favorite, one of the dog's favorites, dude. And you know what? You did a pretty good job of it. There were a couple little pitch things in there, but I don't know, dude. There's something about you. I see... Me and you or something, dude. I just like you, dude.
I like that.
I like you, dude. You're definitely in the dog pound for real.
Thank you.
Oh, it's a dog pound. Shut your face. Mm.
It takes a lot of courage to start the song sitting about 10 feet away from Simon.
Yeah.
It really does.
See?
And you know what? What I love about you, Kevin, is you've got more... moxie than most people I've ever met in my entire life, and that's what's going to carry you on throughout this competition. People adore you.
No, it's not.
You did another good job tonight.
Thank you. Yeah. All right, Simon.
Kevin.
Yes.
Simon, of course.
I like you.
I know, and I like you, Simon.
No, I do. I like you. You know, because you're like a man. You know, you take it well. And I'm not going to say it was the best version of that song I've ever heard, because it wasn't. However, you know, I think, who your audience is, and I think your audience are going to love that version. So, thank you.
The grandmas. You talk about how the grannies there love them. And
I think Simon showed a little heart there, because I think Simon knew he was definitely going to be gone. So he's like, you know what, I don't need to smash
him
anymore.
Why am I going to beat him up?
So
yeah.
I'll be nice, knowing that this is pretty much it for the kid.
Yeah.
You know, that's what I like about Simon. Yeah. And then Ryan has to go up there and, oh, do you have any constructive criticism for these contestants?
No.
As Ryan sits there and tries to make them cry, they're getting kicked off.
Ryan is he's every guy whose face you want to throw acid in. His fucking dumb, boyish smile and his good teeth, he really makes me sick.
He's making a lot of money.
He certainly is. He's probably banging a lot of girls. I'm fiercely jealous.
So, finally, before we move on, we got Seth Green outside the studio here. He's going to come in and say hi.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Daughtry. There's a little controversy here.
Controversy.
Can we play his version of Walk the Line and then we'll get into the controversy? I didn't even see this in the paper, so I don't know where you're getting this from, but you're accurate, Ann.
Opie, I did some investigative reporting of my own here and found this out.
Right.
Via Fox News.
Jimmy, because you're not really watching American Idol, Chris Daughtry, who Ann and I have no doubt is going to win the whole damn thing. It's not even a contest.
Is he the
anymore.
Guy, the band guy? He's like a rock
he's
band?
Like rocker kind of guy.
Yeah, he's like an alt rock.
It's
singer.
Now this contest at American Idol is for second place.
Absolutely,
it's for second place.
It's not even close.
If this guy doesn't run away with this, it's a travesty.
And now every time they mention his name, the whole place just gives him a standing ovation. Well, whatever.
He's a rock star.
They're cheering like crazy, more for him than anybody.
He's got the presence, the look, and the voice. Okay. And he just every week runs away with it. And he did Walk the Line.
The Johnny Cash song?
Very, very different version of Walk the Line. It totally fits his style and everything.
You wouldn't even recognize it as a Johnny Cash song.
He had a little trouble at the beginning with the very low notes in there. It's very hard to sing very low, but then at the middle and the end of the song, he brings it home, and it's really good.
Yeah, listen to his version of Walk the Line. It gave me like goosebumps when I was listening to this the other day.
I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day's through. Yes, I admit I'm able for you, because you're mine, I walk the line. Cause sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right, because you're mine, I walk the line. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Yeah, keep me on your side, yeah. With love that I can't hide. I'd even try to turn the tide, yeah.
Now, Jimmy, you're a big Johnny Cash fan. What do you think of that version? It's unbelievable, right?
And he sounded more like Cash than that fucking Joaquin Phoenix did.
You're obsessed. He is so obsessed with Joaquin Phoenix playing Johnny Cash.
It makes me sick.
You can't let it go.
I never can let that go.
You can't let it go.
And he sounded more like Cash.
However, that version was great, man. That was great. That could be
guy's
on the radio tomorrow, right?
Voice is amazing.
That could easily be on the radio tomorrow, right? Well, this is what the judges said, and then we'll get into the controversy. That's starting to hit. I haven't seen it in the papers, but Anthony already...
Hey, I'm on top of
Anthony
things.
Might have started this.
I'm on top of things.
He might have started this controversy, actually. But this is what the judges had to say to Chris Daughtry.
Let me say this. I don't know if I think it was the best vocals you've done since you've been on the show, but what I loved about this is that you took a song that everyone knows, you put a different spin on it, made it an alternative record that fit exactly who you are, and I love every week that you know exactly who you are, and you never veer from that path.
Amen.
So it's always cool, dude. You ready? You ready? You ready, baby? You ready? I like that.
American Idols on stage that I wait for every week. I can't wait to hear what you're going to sing and what you're going to do. You are so true to who you are, and you don't ever abandon that. And that's what's so amazing about you, Chris. And it's like you grow and you grow each week. I don't even...
He's real,
Paula. Like, you are... You should be already touring, and we should be buying tickets for a concert.
Chris, I agree with Randy. I don't think it was the best vocal we've heard from you so far, but I don't think it matters because there was an enormous difference between what you just did then, which is to take a great song, make it your own version. It was completely the opposite to what I hated about Bucky's version of Oh Boy. And actually, I've got to tell you, I think you are the first artist we've ever had on this show who's actually refused to compromise. And for that, round of applause. Mm.
So the judges obviously loved that version and kept saying that how he made it his own.
Little subliminal things going on, too. Did you hear how Simon called him the first artist on the show? Like, it's not contestant. It's not the guy. He called him an artist. You know, that kind of little things like that get the vote. Like, this guy needs any help, but you know, it's those little things stick in America's minds when they vote. It's a great version, but was it his? Was it his idea? To arrange it that way. What they did was they brought in super fag Barry Manilow, and he helped arrange.
What is going on? He seems like a really nice guy, but...
He certainly does.
How much plastic surgery has he had?
I don't know.
There is just something going on with that body.
He's a Brooklyn
guy.
You can't totally bash him, but he wrote the songs that made the young girls cry, Opie, too. He wrote the songs. He wrote the songs.
Mandy.
Yeah.
he came into my life.
he helped arrange some of these songs because it was 50s. They had to do songs from the 50s and different little versions of them. And then Chris came in and had this idea for Walk the Line, and apparently wasn't quite his own.
Right.
He says on his website that he's influenced, and one of the bands that have influenced him was Live. And then we find out that Live put out an album a couple of years back with a cover of Walk the Line on it. And there's some similarities there. You're a little Live.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
The beginning, exactly the same.
I find it very, very easy to be true.
Oops.
I find myself alone when each day is through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you, because you're mine, I walk the line. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And the happiness I've known proves that it's right, because you're mine, I walk the line.
Thank you.
You give me cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
Just waiting to see if it kicks in.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide.
They get a little longer arrangement too, you know.
Yeah.
I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Because you're mine, I walk.
So obviously very similar to what he did on American Idol the other night.
He really like brought it home and rocked it out a lot more.
I got to tell you.
But the arrangement is the same.
It's the same arrangement, but yeah. Chris Daughtry on American Idol did it better.
Did it better, yeah.
Did it better, proving how talented this kid is.
I disagree. Yep.
And does he have to tell the judges where that came from?
No.
They were just complimenting him, and he was just nodding away. Was it his place to go, well, I got that arrangement
from live.
And does it matter in the end? Probably not, right?
I like Lives better. I got to be honest. I like Lives better.
Really?
I like Chris's. Yeah, but I like Lives better.
Well, Chris threw it together in a day, though. I think I like Chris Daughtry's version better.
Yeah,
because he really rocks it out, man. Yeah, you'll take Cash, obviously.
But I like Joaquin, actually. His version was
the
best out of all of them.
Joaquin's version of Walk the Line in the movie was unbelievable, Jimmy.
Was it?
We got Seth Green.
That's...
So there's the controversy with American Idol. I don't know. We'll see where it goes. I don't think it's going to go anywhere. But it's just interesting to know that Live did that song. And actually, no one cared because I never heard that on the radio.
No. So not one of their big hits.